Oh man, Summer Azusa is here. She slices, she dices, she does all the meta things you would love. She's a top tier waifu. So let's go ahead and review her. Let's just roll right into the review here. All right, we got Summer Azusa. You know the drill. We're going to go over the abilities. We're going to go over the stats. And we're going to go over my take on it. I've been very excited for this unit. Very, very excited. Is she meta? Yes. Is she amazing live 2D? Yes. Is she? And you'll see this in this video. Is she amazing for just everything? I mean, she really is. She really is. So let's start with the right-hand side like we normally do. She is a mystic damage type. She is an attacker middle. She is Trinity, and we've had a lot of Trinity recently. So balancing those Trinity books between Azusa, Summer Azusa, and Koharu has been very difficult as of late. She does have an assault rifle with gloves, hairpin, and watch per normal for assault rifle. Not too keen on her affinity, sadly. She does have the Iori affinity. It's the same one, but usually doesn't matter. But she's going to be really good for Shirokuru and a bunch of others anyways, when it's indoors, especially. Oh, by the way, if you're still here, quick plug, make sure you hit that subscribe button, hit that like button. If you do like this video, it helps us reach a wider audience, which helps us find more people. Come join us in the Discord, Twitch, TV, yada, 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 yada. Let's go back into it. Going over to the character stats. We have her 5-star right now. Typical damage across the board for an assault rifle, 2584. Pretty good. That will also get buffed. We'll go over her skill in a little bit, but that'll get buffed by herself personally. She's a little bit more crit rate than we typically see. You usually see around the 200, so that's always nice to see. Crit damage, very nice to see. And decent amount of HP, nothing to write home about on that. It is nice that she is a middle, so she does get that 700 evasion, which does help out a ton. And then everything else is nothing to write home about there. Let's get into these abilities and why they're so amazing. So the first one is an EX cost 5, which deals 847 damage to a single enemy and then applies a 640% continuous cold damage dot for over 20 seconds. This is big damage, huge damage. Absolutely amazing. Normal skill, every 35 seconds increases crit damage by 40%. That is huge, for 30 seconds. So essentially, she only has about 5 seconds of downtime. That's wonderful. Increases attack by 26%. And then finally, her bread and butter on why you bring her to a ton of raids and not just a few raids is when attacking, there's a 30% chance to reduce the target's defense by 15.3% for 13 seconds with a 5-second cooldown. That is typically going to be up a large majority of the time without crunching some major big brain numbers. It's just up for a long time. Trust me, I've seen it. It is just up there. So I want to interrupt real quick and talk about the defense breaker from Summer Azusa. So defense breakers will stack, but only certain ones will stack. So essentially, we could put these into three different categories. There's the category one, which is the EX skill, kind of like Akane, which will stack with category two, which is like Azusa and Maki, which have the same type of defense breaker. And then you have category three, which is a different type of defense breaker, which is Summer Azusa. So you can have one from each category, and that's what makes her very powerful in raids that she's not even really that great in, is for that defense stacking. So looking at these skills, we're going to try and order these real quick. Obviously, your EX skill, you're going to want to max out EX 5. Her sub skill is probably the first 10 you're going to want to do, because that 15.3% is very good. It's very good for all the other raids that you're going to bring her to. And then what I would do is I'd probably level her normal and passive skill at the same time, bring them both to 7, and then, you know, maybe just choose one. Both are going to give you some great mileage. I personally always love raw attack, but since the duration is so good on this, 30 seconds every 35 seconds, this could be done as well. But she's probably one of the few students that I actually recommend that you need to do 5, 10, 10, 10 on her. She doesn't get replaced like almost ever, or at least that I have seen. I know there's a lot of new anniversary students coming out, but that's a while down the road. Looking at her unique weapon, it is increases her indoor affinity to double S. Once again, I don't usually like students that do that. I know most do. I really wish they would bring up some of these other ones to maybe neutral or something like that. And then increases her attack further by an additional raw amount of attack and attack percent. So that's absolutely amazing. So she's just amazing across the board, guys. She really is. Let's check out the raids that you're going to bring her in, and then go check out her live 2D and all that goodness. All right, first place you're going to bring her is Shirokuru. She's designed purely for it. But the other places you're going to bring her is Hero Ninmis and Binna, because she's going to be used for that defense breaker for stacking those teams. Now, she can't be used for Cheese and Kaiten and the Big Chicken, depending if you're doing multi-teaming, but we're not really going to bring that up. Now, lucky for us, Shirokuru is the only one that Summer Azusa really needs to do a lot of damage on, and you're not just bringing her for utility. So Shirokuru is indoors and urban, which gives her a positive and a negative affinity. So depending on which version of Shirokuru you're going to be going up against, you're going to see a 40% damage swing, which is okay. Some of the other DPS you bring in there should be able to compensate that, but I think most DPS lean towards indoors, so it does get a little dicey on the urban. And once again, we don't really need to bring up any of the other raids because she's really just being brought in for a defense breaker, so we're gonna go ahead and just move forward with this review. All right, let's talk about general content real quick. Now, she is pretty useful in a lot of general content. She could be useful in bounties for this Desert Railroad. You know, we have that Trinity stack down there in the bottom left-hand corner. Now that we have Koharu, Azusa, and a few others, it's going to be a lot easier to get past Railroad if you're still struggling on that. You could plug her in there for some defense breaking and a little bit of damage. I wouldn't focus on her damage, honestly. Next up on commissions, she is very, very good for item retrieval. So if you're struggling with this item retrieval right here, she's going to be able to help you out. Now, Izuna and a few others, Haruna, are going to go a long ways here as well, but she could definitely help you out on item retrieval. Not so much base defense. And then just general progression, right? As you're trying to make it through some of these missions where you have to do special units and light units and stuff like that, right? You could plug her into your secondary team, and she's going to help you get through that a little bit faster. Now, these special units are very annoying, but we need more Mystic. We always need more Mystic, and depending on when you're watching this review, you may not have enough. So she's perfectly capable in a lot of content. She's not really capable in tactical challenge in PvP. I'm sure there's some team out there that can plug her in, but I wouldn't really heavily rely on her for that. All right, and that brings us to our final rating. Now, I know she's not useful in PvP, but she is amazing. Great live 2D, absolutely a cuteness factor times 10,000. She's useful in a lot of different raids. She's a meta unit. She's useful in any other kind of content that you need Mystic units for until we get more in the Gambit. So the final pull rating that we have here is a 5. Out of 5, must pull, must do it. I don't care what you have to do, like go work some chores or something, right? You know, make the you know, go ask for the 20-40 bucks. No, I'm just kidding there. But seriously, like go through all your Momo talks, try and get as much resources. We do have the event depending on when you're watching this video, so hopefully you should be able to pull it, and I wish you guys luck trying to pull Summer Azusa. She's amazing, and let me know in the comments down below what you know, how they went, you know, and how your pulls went and all that goodness. So I will see you guys on the next video. We'll have the live 2D right after this, so feel free to drop that subscribe and like button. Again, come join us on the Discord, and I will see you next time.
初めて。目に映る全部がキラキラして、すごい。何にも邪魔されずに、こうして何もかも見渡せる場所があったなんて、なんだか不思議な感覚。もともとこういう開けた場所はあまり好きじゃなかった。隠れる場所もないし、周囲の警戒も大変で。でも今は全然不安じゃない。きっとこれは、今の私の視界にはいつもこうやって先生がいてくれるからかな。
Ha 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 ha!